I've been thinking about the good times. I've been sleeping through the long night. I've been shining in the sunlight. I've been thinking how I'm alright. There's a reason for my feelings. There's a reason why I'm healing. Yeah, I feel higher than the ceiling. All because of you. You and I are so sweet, so sweet. Talk until we asleep, asleep. Every night I fall deep.
What's up, y'all? Welcome back to my channel. So today we got my son Ali, we got Raven and Takia. They're back.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So today we celebrating Tupac. You feel me?
Period.
Today his B-day, and we thought, what better to do your boy up than to get what he like to eat? You feel me? Well, one of the things. You know, I'm sure he got other favorites. So we have a huge spread. We got chicken. We got nachos, we got chips and guac, we got broccoli,
corn, rice,
beans, and we got
and then they come with the shells.
Yeah.
Taco shells.
And I got some spicy shrimp. What was these called? Street tacos.
Street tacos. Mm. And then I got the avocado corn tacos. Well, street tacos, and then I got, well, no, I had two of those.
This is my first time eating here. I never ate here before, so I'm excited to try some of everything. So let's get started.
Oh yeah, and it's from El Pollo Loco.
Yeah. No, I don't think you did.
No. I'm gonna get some of these sauces.
Yes.
This is pico de gallo.
It smells so good too.
Mmm. Okay.
It
smells fire.
I don't think there's no rice
left.
I doubt it.
We going
wait.
You can have this, Ali.
I actually don't like the sauce on here.
On which one?
The spicy taco.
Oh, the spicy.
The shrimp taco?
Yeah.
These avocado tacos is fire. I'm gonna tell you, baby. Fire. Okay?
The rice and the corn.
I don't know what's on this. Mm. I don't like
it's
it too much.
Okay, so that one was not a hit.
Nah, I'm not. I'm not.
Gonna eat it. You don't like the shrimp street taco.
Nah, I don't like that.
The sauce messed it up.
So, what we're gonna talk about today is Tupac and how he influenced the world and the music industry. And we know how talented he was, or is, for people who think he's still alive, like myself. I've been here a lot. What y'all think?
I do not think Tupac is still alive. Although, I would love to think that he is. I just don't think he is.
Your boy in Cuba.
His time would have been up for him to come back.
He don't want to come back here.
I don't think your boy is alive, unfortunately.
Well, what you think about his music?
Well, we all know that Tupac was a legend.
Period.
He had all hits. He had hits on top of hits on top of hits.
Period.
And then, like, in the short span of his career, you know, he had so much in his catalog.
Mm-hmm.
So, that was just amazing. In itself, like his catalog in general. So I don't know. I love Tupac. I think he was very, very, very profound.
Mm-hmm.
He was definitely prolific. Am I saying that right?
Yeah.
So yeah, but Tupac was awesome. That's my take on that.
I'm gonna tell y'all a quick story. When I was in high school, I went to an all-girls school, and in my music class, we had a assignment to do, and it was do a report on your favorite artist. And so I chose Tupac, and the song I chose was Broken Wings.
Wings.
I had to play the song for everybody, and then talk about why I love that song so much, right? So after I played the song, I look over my teacher, and my teacher is, she was white, she was Caucasian. She was in tears. And I explained to everybody why it was my favorite song, blah, blah, blah. And so she spoke after me, and she was like, thank you so much for sharing this. She was like, this is the first time, she didn't even know nothing about Tupac, never heard his music, never heard of him or anything. She was like, this is the first time that I heard a rapper not use one curse word in his whole entire song. And she was saying the things that he said in that song, she said, it just touched my heart. And she said, thank you for introducing him to me. And I guess ever since then, she looked your boy up.
That was beautiful.
Yes, it was. I felt like I did something. You know what I'm saying? I'm like, ooh, I changed the girl. Mm-hmm. I changed the heart.
Cause like most of the time, most people think of rap and they just like
think of degrading music.
Yeah, those hoodlums. They don't know what they're talking about.
And Tupac, what I love the most about Tupac is that he wasn't
Sorry y'all, this is spicy.
Mm-hmm.
What is that?
It's red salt.
I like it.
It's good, but it's
hot
at first, and then
I like spicy.
Mm-hmm.
No, I think it's the same thing that's on that taco. I don't like that.
That's why I told you to smell it first.
It's something in there that I don't like.
I told her to smell it first. I had an instinct.
But like I was saying, one thing I love about Tupac is the fact that he wasn't no punk. He ain't want nobody.
Period.
Punk him, he stood up for what he believed in. He didn't back down from nothing. And he stood up for black people. He stood up for just human rights, period. You know what I'm saying? He loved humanity. Mm-hmm. He wanted everybody to like get along and, you know, do for self. He was all about change, you know, and all about, if you want to see a change, start with yourself first. You get what I'm saying? And I just love that about him. And I'll never forget when I found out he had passed. When they announced he had passed, I was in my dad's car, and it came on the radio, and I just broke down. Like, I couldn't believe, because I felt, when I was a teenager, I felt like, ooh, like, I'm gonna meet him one day. Like, I can't wait. Like, I know, I just knew I was gonna meet him. And, of course, that never happened, but I feel like I did meet him. Through his music.
So that was like the thing that he was able to leave behind, because you know, when you think about like leaving behind, what's gonna be your legacy that you have to leave to the world? And that was his legacy, his thoughts, his passion, his voice, like everything. So I mean, I don't know, I can't even put my words together.
He was a poet.
Yeah. Now he had some ratchet stuff. You feel me? He did have his ratchetness.
But and heart though.
Yeah.
I feel like that was just for like to make it
for in the rap. Yeah.
But at heart, the core of his heart, he was poetic.
Absolutely.
You know, a rose that grew from concrete. Like, who in the hell did he even come up with that?
Yes.
Genius.
Genius.
Man was touched by God.
Yes.
Period. Mm-hmm. It was like you can feel his soul through his poetry, through his music. And I loved how he loved, you know, women, especially black women. Like, he uplifted women and, you know, held men accountable for the stuff that they do. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? How they treated women. I love Tupac.
Me too.
Period.
He's like definitely one of my all-time favorites.
Yes. I used to get into arguments with people.
Don't say it.
People who did not like Tupac.
We ain't gonna talk about the Zed.
Yeah, we ain't gonna talk about the Zed, but still. Like,
right now, let's just say we on the West Coast. Period. Okay.
Period.
Yeah.
What you got to say, Ali?
Being a really grow up during that era, but I definitely still do listen to Tupac. I think he's a great person.
Mm-hmm. Do you think his music coincides with what's going on in the world today?
yeah, some of his music, but I don't think people connect that, those references to music.
To what's going on now.
Yeah.
Well, I do. Do you think a lot of young people know about Tupac?
Yeah, that's what I was gonna ask. Like, people in your generation. Cause you know, you got all your young boys, all your, everybody got a young boy or something in their
right,
name.
Right,
right. They definitely know who Tupac is, but I don't think they understand or appreciate him the way he should or should be.
I definitely understand that. Tupac was an amazing man. Amazing. Like, you can take his music and and make it relate to what's going on in the world today.
Yep.
And it's one quote he said that I really, really love is, "I might not change the world, but I'll spark the brain that will change it." Woo! Come on.
That's gonna be me.
He was talking about your girl.
Period.
Definitely talking about your girl.
I love him. Did y'all taste this chips and guac?
The what?
The chips and guac.
I did. You know, the guac need a little salt.
Oh. A little bland.
A little bland.
Those churros are amazing.
The churros are amazing.
But this green sauce with these chips is good.
The green sauce that
I the green sauce.
I didn't even open up the green sauce. There was a lot of green sauce.
Y'all, this is my first time. I am cheating. It was my first time eating chicken in a year.
Yeah. Oh my God, yes, Tuffy, she told y'all she was vegan.
I ate, not vegan.
Okay,
vegetarian, because I eat fish, but I'm cheating today for Tupac. Don't judge me. I'll be back on.
Well, this green sauce is good.
Yeah, it is. I want to try it with this chicken. Anyway, she's a fraud.
She lied.
Well, I really didn't. I am cheating though. Seriously, I'm probably gonna be sick after this.
Let's hope not. Yeah, this chips and green salsa is fire. It's way better than the guac.
Bro, this chicken is so damn good. Y'all gotta dip it in the green sauce.
What, dip the chicken?
Baby.
But the red sauce was kind of a little spicy to me.
Yeah, it's a little spicy.
I mean, your girl been missing out.
It got that barbacoa taste to it. You know what I'm saying? Smoky.
No, I do like it.
Yeah. This place is literally right across the street from me. And I've never been in there.
It takes your girl Raven to tell us to go to Oil Pollo Loco.
Yeah, it was my idea.
I've been there like a long, long time ago, but I can't remember how it is, but it's good. I like it. These tacos from here are actually really, really good too.
This was one of Tupac's favorite places.
That's right.
Do you know what his favorite meal from here was? Did they say?
He just, that one of the outlaws dudes, he just like chicken. He said chicken.
From El Pollo Loco.
I'm guessing it's just chicken. I don't know.
So I mean, they do sell chicken.
But he also liked Creole food. Like, in one of his notebooks he had that he wanted to open up a restaurant that catered to Creole food. And he had it all mapped out, the name, the names of the bathroom. He wanted the bathroom to say Players for men and Divas for women.
Aww.
Yeah, and, chicken and waffles he wanted in there. What else was one of the dishes? Catfish, collard greens, type of Creole. It's like a seafood, but a Creole soul food restaurant. Yeah.
Mm. That's cool.
I thought that was dope.
You should fulfill his destiny.
Somebody already just did.
Who? Really? Yeah,
somebody, I think in New York, this white guy. I just saw him when I was looking up the stuff online, like what his favorite food was. Mm-hmm. They just opened up the exact restaurant.
Are you serious?
Name and everything. And I was wondering, like, I guess he can do that. It's not illegal, right?
I mean, I guess yeah. He didn't have
no paperwork on yeah. it. So. I just thought that was kind of
funny.
Because
everything.
I don't know. Mm-mm. These nachos are okay. They're not the best. I don't like the chicken that's in these nachos, but I do like this. Is this like a rotisserie chicken?
This is flame grilled chicken.
It's so good, y'all.
And they marinate it in a sauce that has like orange zest. Not zest, but like the squeeze and orange in it. And like all these spices.
Is that a guy? I don't like that. Mm-hmm. Sorry, I'm touching on all the chicken.
Yeah, on all of these.
Sorry.
I don't like that.
My hands clean.
Barely. So what else, y'all? What y'all else got to say about your boo? I don't know. Maybe they didn't really talk. Well, y'all said everything I wanted to say. The man was a genius.
Mm-hmm.
He was gifted. And he shared his gifts with the world. Mm-hmm. He didn't die with his gifts in his pocket. He shared
Come on.
He blessed us.
Sure did.
And we appreciate it. And I appreciate God.
They got churros, y'all. They're pretty good. It's not like I don't know.
It's not like Disneyland quality. I don't know if you have the churros at Disneyland, but people go crazy for those. I never been to Disneyland.
It's okay. It's not bad. But it's not the best. But comment down below y'all favorite Tupac song. My favorite Tupac song. Man, I got so many. The girl, when I want to turn up, I like to listen to Toss It Up. You feel me?
Why you steal my song, bruh?
I love that song. I love Hail Mary.
Hail Mary. Mm-hmm. That's a good one.
That's my song.
My other one is I Ain't Mad At You.
That's my jam. That one makes your girl crack. I like that song.
Because of the video. Because it was like his death kind of like.
Exactly.
Yeah. But I still love the song.
I like Dear Mama.
Mm-hmm.
I like Brenda Got a Baby.
Yeah, that was a good one too.
I like, man, it's so many. Oh, Girlfriend. Me and my girlfriend. Yeah. That's my jam. I got that on my playlist right now, baby. The girl be in there. Let's go.
Wait, what's my other one? Man, I can't even think of the name.
I got so many.
All Eyes on Me. Oh, yes. That's a good one. Yeah.
Comment down below if y'all know Tupac, the dance he did in every video. I'm awake. I'm finna show y'all.
Yeah, boy. Yeah.
That's your boy dance right there, okay?
Period.
Let me see, what other songs? I love all his music. Oh, to live and die in LA is the place to be.
You don't want to get copyright.
That song made me want to move to LA. Do you hear me?
Listen.
I was like, bro, we gotta go. We gotta go to LA. Your boy there right now. I'm in Vegas. Feel me?
Girl. What's the other one with him and Dr. Dre?
California Love.
California. Hey.
Oh yeah. Oh my god.
Damn. But yeah, we can't sing the songs, but y'all know.
Y'all know what we're talking about. I wonder if he was alive, what would he be doing right now? Like, But the boy had ran for president.
I definitely think he'll be doing me? Some type of activism.
Oh, yeah, definitely. He will be an activist for sure. Yeah.
I love Tupac. He was a handsome, fine man. You know what I love the most about his features? His thick eyebrows and those sultry eyes. Oh my God. Woo! Anyway, y'all.
Chill out, sis.
Make sure y'all like, comment, share, subscribe, and let me know down below again y'all favorite Tupac song or quote or whatever. And hit a like and a like for your girl. You feel me? Love you. Bye.
See ya.
Everybody wanna party and function. I'm gon' make music for the function. What time here come destruction? What time tearing down construction? Everybody wanna party and function. I'ma make music for the function.